Hi everyone, this is Yang Jiao. In this presentation, I will introduce you a space vector modulation for the three-level neutral point clamp converter. This modulation scheme will balance neutral point voltage as well as reduce the switching loss.
First, let me briefly review the system structure for this power conversion system. The DC-AC converter provides a bidirectional power flow between the 480 volt utility grid and 1200 volt DC link. The DC-DC converter connects the DC bus, which can be different renewable energy, energy storage system, or nanogrid system. Both of these two stages are constructed by this modularized face-like building block. The system has 200 kVA power rating and 20 kHz switching frequency with bidirectional power flow. For the 3-level NPC converter, each face leg is a 3-pole 1/3 switch. The 3-phase system has total 27 switching status with 6 long, 6 medium, 12 small, and 3 zero vectors. And the rotating voltage reference can be synthesized by the nearest 3 vectors. By using the only nearest 3 vectors, causes less switching events and related DVDT and switching loss. Also, a parallelogram sector division method is used for calculation simplicities. Neutral point voltage balance is critical to the 3-level converter. Small vectors are used to balance the NP voltage. With NP voltage imbalance defined, the two switching status for one small vector have opposite neutral voltage and current. The opposite influence on the neutral voltage is selected for NP balance, and the selection is based on the neutral current and voltage feedback. If NP voltage is positive, the small vectors are selected to reduce the delta V, and then the NP imbalance is negative. Another small vector are used to increase delta V. Oppositely, if delta V is still larger than zero, after one cycle, the same small vectors are used in the next cycles so that NP voltage is balanced. The selected switching status can result in different pulse sequence patterns. Pattern 1 is asymmetrical sequence, and pattern 2 is symmetrical sequence with multiple switching events. Pattern 3 is symmetrical sequence with least switching events. And the THD comparison shows that symmetrical sequence has smaller THD. And also, a total system loss breakdown gives loss comparison for the three patterns. From the above result, it is shown that pattern 3 is the most desired switching patterns in one switching cycle. The pulse sequence patterns are also influenced by the power factor. Under unity power factor case, the vector selection always enables the desired pattern 3 to happen, but under non-unity power factor case, the vector selection results in the undesired pattern 4, which has double switching frequencies and switching events. The loss for pattern 4 will be largely increased compared with pattern 3. In the space vector diagram, the unity power factor has only pattern 3s in the whole areas, while the non-unity power factor has pattern 3 in green areas in the diagrams, and a combined pattern 3 and 4 in the star-shaped yellow areas. For the two patterns, the following figures shows how frequently they happen in a line cycle. Pattern 3 is indicated as green zone and pattern 4 as red zone. The lower the power factor is, the higher possibilities for the undesired pattern 4 to happen. For the conventional SVM method, a small vector is selected prior to the pulse sequence alignment, and the improved SVM coordinately selects the small vector, considering both the NP balance and pulse sequence patterns, so that we can eliminate the undesired pattern 4 at non-unity power factor. So with this improved SVM scheme, the total system loss can be reduced, especially at low power factor case as shown in this loss breakdown chart. The system efficiency can be improved at low power factor case, and the neutral point voltage balance result is also compared. The proposed method sacrifices a little NP voltage at low power factor to gain loss reductions, but for high power factors, the NP voltage is rarely sacrificed, so the proposed method can achieve good NP balancing as well as reduce system loss.
The proposed modulation scheme is verified by experiments on this 3-level neutral point clamp converter. The power state is consisted by this modularized building block. The grid interface is this LCL filter with damping circuit and also starting circuit and sensor board mounted on the power stage.
The first experiment on this 3-level neutral point clamp converter shows the basic operation of this converter functions.
This yellow waveform is a 3-level output voltage for phase A phase to neutral.
and this 3 sinusoidal waveform is the grid current in line frequency. The neutral point voltage with SPWM modulation is then tested as comparison. The yellow curve are phase A output voltage and the green curve are phase A current. This blue and purple curve are the DC link capacitors for the neutral point DC link. And this is the neutral point voltage in balance. You can observe a large voltage ripple on the DC link capacitors and also the neutral point voltage without balancing. The neutral point voltage with the proposed SVM modulation is tested for verifications for the NP balancing result. The yellow curve are phase A output voltage and the green curve are phase A current. These blue and purple curves are the DC link capacitors for the top and bottom DC link cap, and this is the neutral point voltage. You can clearly see that there is no ripples on the DC link capacitor voltage and neutral point voltage. The three-phase output voltage waveform is also observed. By zooming in this waveform to several switching cycles, the power sequence alignment can be clearly identified. In each switching cycle, the power sequence is center aligned, and also there are only 4 switching events in each cycle, which is the desired switching patterns as we mentioned before.